saving me from what I might have been. Let me thank you.
Thank you.
Well, again.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Let me thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Oh, hallelujah.
Again.
Hallelujah.
Well, you gave me. Oh, brand new beginning. When you freed me from all my guilt and shame.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, you gave me.
Oh, hallelujah.
Well, a brand new.
Oh, hallelujah.
Reason for living.
Yes, Lord. Welcome, welcome to the Heart for God Network.
I just want to thank you.
I want to thank him. I want to thank him.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. This is Minister Norman with you tonight within the Heart for God Network. Praising God forever. We're going up to the mountain. We're going to thank God tonight. We're going to thank you for his mercy and his goodness towards us. I want to thank you, Lord.
For saving me.
Oh God. Thank you,
from
Jesus.
All my mind.
Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord, yes. Let me thank you.
Oh God.
Again. The Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. I want to thank you, Lord. I want to thank you.
Let me thank you.
Oh God, I want to thank you with my entire life. I want to thank you for what you have done for me. You took my place upon the cross. You took my place, Lord. So I want to thank you with my entire being. My entire life belongs to Jesus. I want to thank him for his goodness towards us. Oh God. We're going to be thanking God forever throughout eternity. Oh, Jesus, thank you, Lord. Thank you for what you have done for me. Thanks for tuning into the Heart for God Network. My God, my God, my God. What a day that will be when we shall see the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. The nails to our hand. Oh, God. I'm thanking him right now. I'm praising him right now. Lord, I want to thank you.
From worry and fear, thank God he has set me free. And now there is a peace that passes all understanding deep down within. The Holy Spirit reaches out and strengthens me, and he guides me. And I just want to say, thank you again. Let me sing that verse one more time. From worry and fear, I've been set free. Oh, and now I have sweet peace within. Oh, your spirit strengthens me for my tomorrows. I just want to thank you. Thank you again. I'll never stop thanking you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
When I climb
The Bible said it was like a mighty rushing wind, and it filled the place where they were sitting. It was like a mighty rushing wind. Hallelujah. My God, give us an ears to hear your voice, Lord. Oh God, my God, we thank you tonight. Thank you for this new beginning, this new life in Christ Jesus. He said, behold, all things are passed away. All things are passed away. And behold, he make all things new. My God, oh God, give us an ears to hear what the Spirit said unto the churches. Father, in the name of Jesus, you give us this life, Lord.
I just want to thank you.
I love this.
Thank you.
I love this. Oh, I love this. I love this. I can play this forever. My God. Jesus.
Let me thank you.
It's a beautiful thing to thank the Lord if we know what we're thanking him for. If somebody save you from hell, pit, save you from oppression, depression, save you from the attack of the enemy, save you, my God, heal your body, why would we praise God?
Yes, Lord, yes.
The Bible said there's none that doeth good but God. He's the one that works in us to do and to do of his good pleasure. Jesus Christ goeth about doing good, healing the sick, open the eyes of the blind. My God.
Oh, let me thank you. Thank you again.
Lord, I want to thank you. Oh God, I want to thank you, Jesus. You are the reason why we are living. All things was made by you and for you, and without you, there was nothing made that was ever made. You said, let there be light. You made man in your image and likeness. And you breathed the breath of life into his nostril, and he became a living soul. My God. You came to save the soul of men. You came to save us, Lord.
From worry and fear. Thank God he has set me free. And now there is a peace that passes all understanding. Deep down within, yes. The Holy Spirit reaches out and strengthens me, and he guides me. And I just want to say, thank you again. Let me sing that verse one more time. From worry and fear, I've been set free. Oh, and now,
oh, hallelujah.
I have sweet peace within. For your spirit strengthens me.
Yes. Yes.
For my tomorrow.
Thank you, Lord.
I just want to thank you.
Oh, God, we can't do without you.
Thank you.
We cannot do without you, Jesus.
Again. I'll never stop thanking you. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you for blood, not for transgression.
Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You will blot out our transgression, the audience that was against us. There was none that could deliver us, Lord. But you came in the likeness of sinful flesh. You came down from 32 from someone's generation, Lord. You came down. Oh God, my God. And whosoever shall receive you, you have given them eternal life. Lord, and I want to thank you tonight, Lord. Thank you for your word that you have given us tonight. Thank you for your word that abides in us, Lord. That you never leave us, nor will you forsake us. Oh God. We pray tonight, Lord, that you cleanse us, wash us, Lord, with thy precious blood. Cleanse us from every sin, Almighty God. Every sin that easily besieges us. Oh God, my God. Thoughts of suicide, thoughts of oppression. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, we come against them strongholds and we bind it in the name of Jesus. You said, whatsoever we bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatsoever we loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. My God, today, Lord, we come against the strong man. We bind the strong man, Lord. Every strong man in our life, Almighty God. Against every homosexual spirit, every lesbian spirit, every, oh God, drug addict, in the name of Jesus. Every lasciviousness, Lord God. Every adulterous spirit, Almighty God. Every Jezebel spirit, we bind it now in the name of Jesus. And we cast down every stronghold, Lord. For there is nothing too hard or impossible for you to do. Oh God, you're able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we could think or imagine. And we thank you tonight, Lord, for the blood that was shed for us on Calvary. You shed it 2,000 years ago, Lord. 2,000 years ago. My God, that blood, the blood, the blood. Never loses powers. Never loses healing powers. Never loses deliverance power. Never lose the power. Oh God, the blood that you shed upon the cross of Calvary. The holy blood, the sanctified blood. The righteous blood of Jesus Christ. My God, we thank you for the blood that was shed for me. Almighty God, goats and bullocks and turtle doves could not cleanse me from my sin. But it took the precious blood of Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God that was slain from the very foundation of the world. And I want to thank you, Lord. I thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus, for your only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him will not perish but have eternal life. Oh God, we thank you for your presence, Lord. We thank you for the victory that you have won upon the cross of Calvary, Lord. For my sin you died. For my sin you paid the price, Lord. You paid it in full. Oh God, the enemy did not want to let us go, Lord. Didn't want to lose us, Lord, Almighty God. But you came and take the key. You took the key from hell and the grave, Almighty God. You took the key from him, Almighty God. And now, Lord God, we are free through the precious blood of Jesus Christ.
Let me sing that verse one more time.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you for what you're doing in our life, Lord, in our presence. Mighty God, we thank you, Lord. You said in all our ways that we should acknowledge you, and you will direct our path. Oh, God, we thank you for loosing every chain of bondage in our life, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, my God, every sin that easily besieges us. Father, in the name of Jesus, we cast down every stronghold. Mighty God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for your spirit. Your spirit, Lord, your spirit. Your spirit, Lord, before where the spirit of the Lord is, there is deliverance, there is liberty. Oh, God, there is peace, there is freedom. Almighty God, without your presence, Lord, we'll have no peace because you are the Prince of Peace.
I'll never stop thanking you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for our weapon of our warfare is not carnal, but it's mighty through God by the pulling down of strongholds. Oh God, we thank you for the word. We thank you for the word. The word that you've given to us. Oh God, the word, mighty God, which is the sword of the Spirit. Father, we thank you. Thank you for the shield of faith, Lord. Oh God, you pray for us, Father Jesus. You pray for us that our faith fail not. You pray for Simon Peter that his faith fail not. You pray for us, Lord. You forever live it to make intercession for us, Lord. We thank you, Almighty God, in the name of Jesus.
One more time on that chorus, please.
Oh God, my God, my God. Jesus, you prayed in the Garden of Gethsemane. Not your will, but the Father's will be done.
My Lord Jesus.
Yes, Lord, the Father's will was done. You said it was finished at the cross of Calvary. Mighty God.
From all.
You said, fear not them that could kill, destroy the body, but fear him that could destroy the body and soul in hell. And I want to thank you.
Let me thank you.
Thank you, Lord God, for the revelation of the Word of God, the Son of God, the Prince of Peace, the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end. Thank you, Lord, for the revelation.
Thank you.
Lord, touch the people tonight. Bring deliverance in your life. Father, in the name of Jesus. Bring deliverance, Lord. Bring deliverance. Father, in the name of Jesus. Bring deliverance. We need to be delivered, Lord. Delivered from the oppressor. Delivered from the lie, the slander, or the back. Oh God, my God, we need to be delivered from every oppression spirit, mighty God. We need to be delivered. We need to be delivered. Oh God, many of us are living in defeat. Oh God, we're living in defeat. The Christians are living in defeat. My God, because we are ignorant of the devil's devices. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the blood. Jesus, thank you for the blood that was shed 2,000 years ago. And it's still, oh God, it's saving us right now. It's saving us, Lord. It never loses power.
Yes, you gave me.
You, Lord.
Well, a brand new.
Oh God, keep our eyes upon you, Lord. There is so much deception in the world, Almighty God. So much deception. You said the enemy comes in like a roaring lion, like an angel of light, Almighty God. My God, my God. We can see it in the atmosphere. We can see it, oh God, in these churches. We can see it, Almighty God, in the nightclubs. We can see it, Almighty God. Satan is a liar and he's a deception. Mighty God. Oh God, open our blinded eyes. Father, in the name of Jesus, that we may know the truth. Because the truth shall make us free.
Yes, Lord, yes.
Oh God, all that is going on in Israel today, Lord. All those things that are going on in Israel today, Lord. Mighty God, bring peace to the place. Bring peace. Oh God, you are the Prince of Peace. Oh God, they're slaughtering women and children, Lord. They're cutting off babies' heads. Almighty God, my God, they're destroying the household. Almighty God, they are killing people. Oh God, my God, in the name of God. But Satan, you are a liar. We bind and curse your work. In the name of Jesus. My God. God, touch the nation of Israel. Touch the nation of Israel. Touch the nations, Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus. And bring deliverance. Lord, you said you will fight against them that fight against us. We should stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Keep our eyes upon you, Lord. Keep our eyes upon you, Father, in the name of Jesus.
From worry and fear, thank God he has set me free. And now there is a peace that passes all understanding. Deep down within, yes. The Holy Spirit reaches out and strengthens me. And he guides me. And I just want to say, thank you again. Let me sing that verse one more time. From worry and fear, I've been set free. Oh, and now I have sweet peace within. Oh, your spirit strengthens me for my tomorrow.
Hallelujah.
I just want to thank you.
Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you. Again. I'll never stop thanking you. Thank you. Again.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
If I have 10,000 tongues, I cannot thank you enough.
Ah, for saving. From all I might have been, let me thank you. Yes, again, Lord Jesus. Glory to God. Oh, let me thank you. Thank you. Time on that chorus, please. Oh, let me thank you. Yes, again.
Thank you.
My Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God.
For saving me from all I might have been. Let me thank you again, Lord Jesus. Oh, let me thank you. Thank you.
Looks like you're guilty. Now what do you say? I spoke up, Your Honor. I have no defense. But that's when mercy walked in.
That covered my
forgiven. When
thank you for mercy. I can't even walk without you, Jesus.
The number
we cannot survive without you, Lord. We
would
cannot walk
surely
without you. You are the vine and we are the branches.
And I thought I could be what I wanted to be. And I thought that I could build all life's sinking sand, but I can't even walk without you holding my hand. You see, I thought I had done a lot on my own, and I thought I could make it through this world all alone.
Thank you, Lamb of God. Thank you, Jesus.
And I thought of myself as a mighty, mighty, mighty big man. But
Lord,
you know
I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Without you holding my hand. Oh, the mountain is too high, and the valley is too wide. But Lord, down on my knees, down on my knees, I learned to stand. It's time to pray. It's time to pray. Hallelujah. I can't even walk without you, Jesus.
I can't even walk
without you holding my
hand. Without you holding my hand.
Oh, the mountain's too high.
The mountain's too high.
And the valley.
And me, Jesus.
Valley.
Jesus, Jesus. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Down on my knees, I learn to stand. Down on my knees, I will learn to stand. My God, people of God, it's in the prayer and the prayer room, the prayer closet. Hallelujah. Shut the closet. Go in the closet and shut up with God in the closet. Moses went up to the mountain. Praise God, in the closet. We need to learn to shut in with God and shut out everything. Shut the devil out. My God. Jesus. Down on my knees, I learned to stand. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. My God, for teaching us to stand upon our knees. To stand on our knees, my God. The battle is not yours. The battle belongs to Jesus. He won the battle. That's why he told Moses, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. People of God, saints of God, we have the victory already. It's already won. We just, all we have to do is to endure until the end. Don't turn back. Praise God, praise God, praise God. This is Minister Norman with you tonight. Praising God forever. We're going up to the mountain and we're going to go talk to God. Yes, we have access into the holies of holies. Praise your name, Jesus. My God, the veil was torn from top to bottom. Do you know how thick that veil was? Not even a couple axes could not pull that thing apart. That's how thick that thing was. My God, that separated us from God. Praise the name of Jesus. But when his blood was shed upon the cross of Calvary, he redeemed us from the curse of the law. Because what the law could not do, because it was weak to our flesh, God came into the world in the likeness of sinful flesh and condemned sin in the flesh. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Jesus is the answer for the world today. He's the only way, the only answer. There was no other way. Jesus prayed to the Father and said, Lord, Father, if it's possible, could you take this cup from me? But Jesus recognized that it wasn't his will, but Father's will be done. You know, we have will for ourselves, you know? But let God's will be done in our lives. The day we said yes to Jesus, you no longer belong to yourself. God wants to use us. He's the potter and we are the clay. So God wants to use our life for the glory of God. All we have to be is available vessels. Available to be used of God. We gotta be available to be used of Him in these last days. We praise God and we honor the Holy Spirit, which is God. Praise the name of Jesus. Because he said he went away to prepare a place for us. And where he is, we shall also be. In my Father's house there are many mansions. And if it was not so, he would not have told us. Thank you, Lord, for the Comforter. Thank you for your presence, your spirit that guides us, guides our way through this wilderness of life. Thank you, Lord, for pouring out your anointing upon your people. You have poured out your anointing, Lord, upon us. It's your anointing that makes the difference. It's your anointing that gives us the victory. The anointing of God is very, very, very important. It's like the oil that's in the motor, or in the wheel. Praise God. Yes. Yes, the Holy Spirit is like the oil that's in the motor of the car engine. If the oil comes out of the car engine, the pistons and the crankshaft and the camshaft and all those moving parts, they will seize up. Stop. Seize up. But we know our God is a moving God. Praise God. When we receive that Holy Spirit, the Bible said on the day of Pentecost, there was a sound there was a sound that came in the room and filled the place where they were sitting, and cloven with tongues of fire was set upon them all. The 120 that did not backslide or turn back into the world. There was more disciples. But the Bible said, many are called, but only few are chosen. Are you one of the chosen? Are you one of the chosen? Hallelujah. God loves us. He loves us with an everlasting love. He loved the nation of Israel. And he put his name there. Because when he come back, he shall step down on the Mount of Olives. And he's going to split the earth. Split the rock. My God, what a day that will be. Jesus, Jesus. Coming through the eastern gate. Praise God, people of God. The Lord is my strength, my light, and my salvation. He's the one that gives us the strength to do what we do. Praise God. Because we know that we have an adversary that don't want us to do God's will. Satan does not want us to do God's will. We can see it in our life. Paul said in the book of Romans, when I want to do good, evil presents itself. Evil. That's the devil. When Daniel prayed, God heard him the first day, but Gabriel was withstood by Satan. He was withstood by Satan. So God after dispatched Michael the archangel to handle his business. Praise God. Oh God, glory to God. The battle is not ours, but the battle belongs to Jesus. Praise God, people of God. Praise God. I do not come with excellency of speech. But in the power of the Spirit. Spirit of God. You know, the more I read the scriptures, I understand when the Bible says the Spirit move upon on the disciples, move upon them, and they wrote the scriptures. So God has to move upon us in these last days. That's why he said, I'm going to pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. Upon all flesh. Black flesh, white flesh, orange flesh, green flesh, humanity. He's going to pour out his Spirit. Whosoever will, let him come and drink. Whosoever will, let him come and drink of the fountain of life, which is Jesus Christ. He is the rock in a weary land. He's the rock that followed the children of Israel in the wilderness and gave them water. He's the living water. He's more mightier than Jacob's well. He's the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. And there is none like him. That's why the angels cry, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. They cry, holy, my God, Jesus. We can't comprehend this as yet. But the little that I know, I'm going to praise God. The Bible said, the fool have said in their heart that there is no God. That's a fool. He could have a Harvard degree, Yale degree, bachelor degrees, doctor's degrees. The fool have said in their heart that there is no God. Paul said, I count everything that I learned as dunk for the excellency of Christ. He went out, God led him out into Arabia to be taught of the Holy Ghost. God is the professor. God is the teacher. He's the instructor. He's a guide. He's the wheel in the middle of the wheel. Praise God forever. We have to continue to pray for for Israel. We have to continue to pray for them. We know that everything that is written in the scripture is going to be fulfilled. It will be fulfilled. The scripture told us that this was going to come to pass. It's going to come to pass. Let us pray for that their eyes might be open. Let us pray for them and keep them in prayer. You know, when I look at YouTube and I see some things that are going on, so some of my guys over there in Israel, they go over there to preach the gospel, and some of the Jewish people them hate them. Even in America, hate the Christians that's preaching the gospel that could liberate them, set them free. But the Bible says the God of this world have blinded the minds of people that they will not believe the truth. Because when you become into the knowledge of God and believe the truth of God, your eyes will be open and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. But they operated underneath the law, the old covenant, the law. Because of their pride and stiff-neckedness, they don't want to believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. They are operating under the law. They don't have anything to cover their sin. No blood, but bullocks, goats, turtle doves. They don't have nothing to cover their sin. But we have Jesus. The blood of Jesus covered my sin 2,000 years ago, and he's doing it still right now today. He saved me by his blood. Praise the Lord. That's how I got saved, by believing the gospel of Jesus Christ. I heard the gospel of Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit. It's a sound that the Holy Spirit makes. The Father, he said, my sheep knows my voice, and they'll go after no other. So we have to know God's voice. It's not going to be in the wind or in the earthquake. It's going to be a small, still voice. It's going to be a voice that said, repent! For the kingdom of God is at hand. And if we're not willing to repent, the Bible said we will die in our sin. We will die in our sin. God is no respecter of person. Whosoever will let him come and drink of the fountain of life freely. Praise God. We thank God for the Lamb of God. We thank God for what he has done. We thank him for his Son, Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him will not perish, but have eternal life, everlasting life. This life is in God. It's in him we live, we move, and have our being. Outside of him, you can't survive. That's why God made man and put him on the earth and gave him oxygen that he could breathe. If you put that same man out in space, he cannot breathe. He will die. We have to live in God's presence, in what Jesus did for us. In him we live, we move, and have our being, in Christ, our Lord. Praise God. Thanks for tuning in to the Heart for God Network. Minister Norman here with you, trying to break the bread of God, of life. The Bible said, if you believe that there is life in these, in the scripture? Search them. Search the scripture. I believe. That's why I dig into the word and search God's scripture. Hallelujah. What do I have to lose? What do I have to lose if I search God's scripture? I got nothing to lose and everything to gain. Praise God. Praise God. Many people are following seducing spirits of doctrines of devils and demons in this world. You got Islam. You got Buddha. You got Krishna. You got Catholic. My God, help your soul. The Bible said, the Father has given him a name. You want to know his name? You want to know his name? Given him a name above every other name. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue confess. That is his name. His name is Jesus. But as I was praying this morning, God showed me this, you know, he kept it in my spirit at all time. He said, the heart of man is deceitfully wicked. He's not talking about a sword that pumps blood. There's a heart, your spirit. The heart of man is deceitfully wicked. You can't trust it. This is why we need the Holy Ghost. This is why we need to be surrendered to God, to be born again, to be baptized, to be filled with His Spirit. And He will lead us and guide us into all truth. The heart is deceitfully wicked. Paul learned this the hard way. God had to knock him off his high horse. He was following his heart, the law. And the law deceived him. The law is of God, it's good. But the enemy used the law to deceive you and to deceive us. He did it in the garden with Adam and Eve. With Adam and Eve, he did it in the garden. The same law which was for life. Be not ignorant of the devil's devices. He got many devices. This is why we need to stick close to God. We need to stick close to Jesus. Keep your eyes upon Him. If you don't keep your eyes upon Him, you will backslide. You will fall into this thing called evolution. Evolving. As some of these preachers talking about, we're evolving. No, we're not. We're the same God today, yesterday, and forever. God never changed. We're involving into. It's like he's saying, you evolve from a monkey to a man. From one single cell into a man. Come on, man. The Bible already tells us that. God made man in his image and likeness. And breathed the breath of life in him, and he became a living soul. Without the breath of God, you are not a living soul. But now you are a living soul. And your soul is seeking for the truth. Your soul is seeking for the truth. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man could go to God. No man could go to the Father except by me. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to be looking at Psalms 85. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, Thou hast been favorable unto thy land. Thou hast brought back the captivity of Judah. Thou hast brought back the captivity of Jacob. He has brought back the captivity of Jacob. The land of Israel belonged to God, and he have given it to Jacob. The captivity of Jacob will end, will only end at the second coming of Jesus Christ. The captivity of Jacob will only end with the second coming of Jesus Christ. When the Jews, the Israel, turn back to God. Who is Lord and Savior? Lord, thou hast been favorable. Favorable unto thy land. God said he loved Israel. He loved Israel. Thou hast brought back the captivity of Judah, Jacob. God has brought back the captivity of Jacob. Thou hast forgiven the iniquity of thy people. Thou hast covered all their sins. He has forgiven them. He has covered their sins. He has covered their sins. So God is saying, all they have to do is to repent and turn to Jesus. Repent and turn to Jesus. Thou hast taken away all thy wrath. Thou hast turned thyself from thy fierceness of thy anger. Thou hast forgiven their iniquity. Thou hast taken away all thy wrath. God is saying, this will bring to pass when Israel accept Christ. When they rejoice so long ago. Thou hast forgiven their iniquity. Thou hast forgiven them of their iniquity. Bible said the lamb that was slain, Jesus Christ, this is the lamb that was slain for their iniquity. And God has turned away the wrath and his fierce anger if they repent and turn to the gift of God that God gave to them. Verse 4. Turn us, O God, of our salvation, and cause thy anger towards us to cease. Turn us, O our salvation, and cause thy anger towards us to cease. Will thou be angry with us forever? Will thou draw out thy anger to all generation? The Bible said God is angry with the wicked every day. But the psalmist David is saying, will thou draw out thine anger to all generation? wilt thou not receive us again, that thy people may rejoice in thee? God is waiting for a cry. God is waiting for a cry. If my people that are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, if my people that are called by my name, humbling themselves and pray, turn from their wicked ways. You know, it's wicked not to receive Christ in your heart. It's wicked not to accept Christ, to deny the only gift of God. It's wicked. Jesus Christ died upon the cross, a brutal punishment for the sins of humanity, and you're not going to receive God's only gift that could save a sin-sick soul, that could save you from going to hell? Show us thy mercy, O Lord, and grant us thy salvation. I will hear what God, the Lord, will speak. For he will speak peace unto his people and to his saints. But let them not turn again to folly. Do not go back into captivity. God wants to speak peace to us. Jesus is the bridge that made peace with God. But many of us turn back to folly. Many of us turn back. The children of Israel want to go back into Egypt, turn back into sin. But God is saying, surely his salvation is nigh them that fear him, that glory may dwell in our land. Salvation is near unto us, that God's presence may dwell with us. Mercy and truth are met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Jesus Christ is that bridge. Jesus Christ is our righteousness, our peace. We have peace with God through Jesus Christ. We was enemy towards God. But because what Jesus done on the cross of Calvary, we have peace. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and righteousness shall look down from the heaven. Yea, the Lord shall give that which is good, and our land shall yield her increase. Righteousness shall go before him and shall set us in the way of his steps. It is the rod and the staff. God's rod and his staff. The staff is to guide us. The rod is to correct us. Rod and staff. Praise God. God is calling us to repentance. He's calling us to repentance. The Bible is being fulfilled in Scripture. It's being fulfilled in the Middle East. It's being fulfilled. The Bible said at midnight there will be a cry. There will be a cry at midnight. When they cry to God, then he's going to come. There will be a cry. So as I say, we have to keep on praying for Israel and for the United States and for the entire world. We have to keep on praying for them. Yea, the Lord shall give that which is good, and our land shall yield or increase. God will give what that which is good, and our land shall yield the increase, shall be blessed. Praise God. The Bible says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High must abide under the shadow of the Almighty. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High must abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Jesus Christ is the answer. He is the solution and he's the answer for the world today. He's the answer. We have to keep our eyes upon the Lord. Keep our eyes upon him. And he will direct our path. People of God, we have to be encouraged. Encourage ourselves in God. Stay on our knees. Fight the battle on our knees. And listen for the sound. We got to hear a sound. The Spirit of God gives a sound. Sound. Real sound. His voice is a sound. The voice of the Lord is the sound. A small, still voice. He speaks to the heart. He said, if your heart condemn you, he is greater than the heart. He's the father of all spirit. He's greater than every spirit. He's the father of all spirit. So if your heart condemn you, he's greater than that. But we have to stay on the knees. until we hear a voice. They were up in the upper room until they hear a voice. The sound like a mighty rushing wind, and it came in and filled the place. But the Lord gave them a hunger, and a thirst for Him. We have to be willing to forsake our wicked ways. We have to be willing to forsake it. For God to live and for God to die. So God is showing us. He said, David said right here, show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. So David is praying for the behalf of his people, Israel. You know, when I was in prayer this morning, I saw something. When Jesus got down on his knees and girded himself with a towel and started to wash his disciples' feet, I saw something there. He started to wash their feet. He did that thing symbolizing that we are to pray for one another. Pray for one another. Pray for one another. We gotta pray for one another. We gotta pray for one another. Pray. We have to pray. It's time to pray. Time to pray. It's time to pray. And this prayer has to come from your heart. The Bible said, a broken and a contrite heart, God will not reject or despise. It has to come from your heart. I'm not talking about a religious prayer here, like the Catholic people them do. It's not a religious thing. We have to know Him on this side. We have to know Christ. We gotta know Him. We gotta receive Him. We gotta be sealed with the Holy Ghost. We gotta be sealed with the fire of God. His presence makes a difference. It's time to pray, people. It's time to pray. The Bible said the flesh is weak. The spirit is willing. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Jesus says, my word, they are spirit and they are life. So we have to open up our mouth and start to pray. It's time to pray. Pray. No religious prayer business going on here. No repetition prayer going on here. We could pray, but we could pray out of our mind and not out of our heart. God's looking for a prayer that comes from your heart. Jonah had to pray, cry out of the bellies. Out of the whale's belly. He was in the whale's belly. And trust me, he gonna pray to get out of there. The Bible says Paul and Silas prayed. They prayed in the prison, and it was loose, it was open. God delivered them. God wanted to deliver his people from every tribe and every tongue. He won't deliver us. Who was born again, blood washed, Holy Ghost filled, water baptized. We are all struggling with something. We're struggling with something. And God wanted to deliver us from that struggle. The Bible said, they that worship me in spirit and in truth. So it got to be in spirit and it got to be in truth. The heart is deceitfully wicked. Who knoweth it? God want to turn the captivity of Israel back to him. He want to turn the captivity of Israel back to him. And it's going to happen on the second coming. This gospel got to be preached. That's why he said, go into all the world and preach the gospel. This cry is going to be made on the second coming of Jesus Christ. The real cry. God love Jacob. Love Israel. God loved that land. He loved it so much that he said, I'll put my name there. And when he's coming back right there. Through the eastern gate. I don't care what devil want to bury them dead there. Walk right over that. That's why the Muslim people is going to put their dead there. But he's Lord of Lords and King of Kings. He's going to come through the eastern gate. He's going to come through it. God has given us time to repent, to seek his face, and to do his will. He's given us time. The people of God, if anything that's in your power to do that which is good, do it unto the Lord. Do it unto him. Do it unto him. Thank you, Jesus. Thou hast taken away all that wrath, that has turned thyself from, thou hast turned thyself from thy fierce of thine anger. He turned himself away from his anger. Why? He said, when I see the blood, I'll pass over them. I'll pass over you. He see the blood of Jesus Christ. So the fierce anger of the Lord, he turned it away from us because of Jesus Christ. We need God's word in these last days. We need God's word to keep us, to guide us, to strengthen us. Don't back away from God's word. No matter how you feel, because your feeling come and goes. You gotta be persistent in God's word. Because we're in a war. It's a warfare we're in. The enemy will do everything in his power to stop us from doing God's work, God's will. Jesus says, not my will. The devil will try to stop Jesus, the Son of God. God. But he was a walking word. Praise God. We have to surrender to God completely. We have to surrender to God. It's not about having church. You could have church. The devil make you have church. But to do God's will? No. He does not want you to do God's will. You ever ask yourself, what is God's will for your life is? You ever ask God that? You gotta ask him that. Unless you don't want to know. His will for our life, he does not want any to perish, but all to come to eternal life. But there is something that we have to do. There's a cross that we have to carry. Every man has to bear his cross. You're not going to go out there and get a piece of stick and carry it. No! There's a cross that you have to carry in this world. Every man has to bear his own cross. If you love Jesus, you'll bear your cross and follow him. Deny yourself. Pick up your cross and follow him. There's a cross that you have to bear. Do you know the cross you have to bear? Jesus carried a heavy cross. He said, it's not burdensome. It's not burdensome, so I have to walk the way he walked. Because God wants to reveal himself to us. We are the salt of the earth, the light of the world. Salt of the earth. We are salt. But if the salt loses savor, it's no good. So there's a cross that everyone has to bear. Jesus is carrying the cross, the heavy, heavy, heavy cross. But we must deny ourselves and pick up our cross daily and follow him. Pick up the cross daily and follow him. Praise God. Meditate upon the word of God day and night. Day and night. Because when the seed of God is being planted, the enemy always come and take it up. Steal it. He come to steal. So the seed have to grow. And the only way it's going to grow, we have to do what Jesus says. Then it's going to grow. Your life is going to grow. In God. Praise God. So God has been favorable unto the land of Israel. God has been favorable to Israel. to his people. His mercy is new every morning. But we have to take action. We have to take action to the his mercy. Something has to happen. Praise God. God bless you guys, and cause His face to shine upon you. Minister Norman here with you, breaking the word of God, studying the word of God, that God's will may be accomplished in our lives, in my life. If God's word don't be accomplished in our life is worth nothing. Nothing. His will must be done. We must find God's will. We have to ask God for the hunger to seek His face, the hunger, the thirst. As we ask God for the hunger and the thirst, He will give it to us. He will give it to us. We cannot be lazy and lukewarm. We can't be lukewarm in these last days. And we can't be lazy in these last days. We have to be ready. We're in a warfare, people. We're in a warfare for our soul. Satan is deceived. He's not going to give up. Because he knows his time is at hand. His time is short. He knows that. So he's going to try to deceive as many, many souls as he can. This is why we need to stick to the Word of God as close as ever before. We're living in perilous times, darker days than before. It might not look like it. Oh, you see church on every corner. Everybody said they're Christian. But let me tell you something. Satan is a liar. If you say you're a Christian and your life have not changed, you are a liar. The devil is lying to you. If you're not growing in God, the devil is lying to you. You have to grow in God. If you're at the same place when you got saved 20, 30 years ago, something is wrong. The Bible said you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. It will make you free. Free to serve God in the capacity that God gives to us. He said He give every man a measure of faith to believe. Every man have a measure of faith. But we have to fight the good fight of faith. We have to fight the good fight of faith. Jesus Christ is a solution to everything. But it's like we don't want the solution. We don't want the antidote. We want to try to solve it ourselves. It's almost like a guy putting something together, and he have an instruction book, but he don't read the instruction book. He just try to put it together. but he's missing some pieces. That's why you have the instruction book. Jesus Christ is the answer for the world today. He's the answer. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. The world is deceived. The whole entire world is deceived. That's why when he started to preach Jesus, things start to happen. You got to preach Jesus. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. For it is the power of God unto salvation. God's power is in the cross of Christ. People of God, God bless you, cause his shine upon you tonight. And keep you in perfect peace. Whose mind is stayed upon him.
I've had questions for tomorrow.
Praise God.
There've been times I didn't know right from wrong. But in every situation, God gave me blessed consolation that my trials come to only make me strong. I've been a lot of places, and I've seen a lot of faces. There are times I felt so all alone. In my lonely hours, those precious lonely Jesus let me know that I was his own. Oh, singing through it all. Through it all.
Some through the fire, but all through the blood.
I've learned to trust in God. Oh, through it all. Him for the storms he's brought me through. For if I never had a problem, how would I know that God could solve it? How would I know what faith in his word could do? That's why I'm up here singing.
Tuned into the Heart for God Network, radio and TV. We come to you 365 days of the year, 7 days a week, and 24 hours a day. Shepherd of the flock is Pastor Howard Palmer. not yet, download the app. You go to the App Store, type in Howard Palmer Ministry.
Well, the Lord says new blessings my way. And he does it over and over and over again. Come on, y'all.
Keep on blessing me. Over and over again.
Oh, yeah. Talking about the Lord now.
You keep on blessing me over and over again. You keep on blessing me over and over again.
Lord, you keep on blessing me.
You keep on blessing me
over and over,
over and over again.
Lord, you keep on blessing me.
You keep on blessing me
over and over,
over and over again.
You woke me up this morning, started me on my way. You gave me strength to make it, to make it through another day. You gave me eyes to see, you gave me a tongue to talk. I wanna thank you, Jesus, for giving me the legs to walk. Lord, you keep on blessing me.
Keep on blessing me.
anything.
He can do anything.
He got the power. He got the power. He got the power. He got the power. My God can do anything. My God, anything.